Okay, now the pond is just up ahead on the other side of those trees.
Fern, I've been to this area a million times. There is absolutely no pond. That's a pond.
Whoa!
Where did this come? I've never seen this.
What he's trying to say?
Welcome to a vernal pond!
But Nature Cat's right. A pond hasn't always been here. We came here in the fall. Roll flashback, please. We were playing leapfrog and Nature Cat jumped into a pile of leaves.
Tally-ho!
There was no pond, just a small depression in the ground. And then when we went sledding last winter, there was no frozen pond.
Tally snow!
Nope, it's called a vernal pond. Vernal means spring, and that's when this pond happens.
So did the pond just magically appear?
Well, kind of. After last winter, the snow melted, and that, along with the rain we've been having, filled up this sunken space. It happens every year. Voila, a vernal pond.
Well, I'd love to hear more about this vernal pond. How about you give it to me in song form?
Hit it! Frog, toad, and salamander all have one great wish. A safe place to lay our eggs that's in water but away from fish. So when the snow melts and spring comes, a cool thing occurs.
What's that?
Some water sticks around to form a temporary habitat.
Wow! Vernal pond! A vernal pond!
It's only here for part of the year, then poof, it's gone. Migrating ducks stop for a swim, and birds like to nest around the rim. They never starve or live off the larva.
Vernal pond!
This is the bestest for bugs and insects.
Vernal pond!
Fairy shrimp thrive here, live their whole lives here. For an amphibian, it beats the Caribbean. You've learned your lesson, a shallow depression
makes vernal ponds.
Watch Nature Cat weekdays on your PBS Kids station or anytime on the PBS Kids video app.